Okay, so welcome to the first video lecture of the course. As I have mentioned, or I'm going to mention, depending on when you're watching this, the way this is going to work is that each lecture is going to be divided into some smaller segments, usually three or four segments that'll be about 15 or 20 minutes. And the purpose of this is to kind of make the material more digestible, because I know fatigue can set in when you're watching very long videos. So it'll be broken up like that. What I'm going to do today is I'm going to introduce a number of concepts and some background theory that are going to be useful in understanding the various readings we're going to look at in the course. And the things we're going to try to understand are, well, first of all, we're going to introduce the notion of a proposition. This is a really important idea that's going to come up again and again, so good place to start is just by understanding what those are. Then we're going to look at a particular theory of propositions called the possible worlds theory of propositions, because it's going to be helpful for the class just to have some sort of background theory to understand, you know, to a concrete thing to work out the views we're going to look at. So we're going to look at the possible worlds theory of propositions. Alright, props, because propositions is a long word. And of course, to do that, we're going to have to spend some time thinking about what a possible world is. So once we've introduced the idea of a proposition and we have an understanding of what the possible worlds theory propositions are, we're just going to spend a little bit more time exploring the possible worlds theory propositions. Because one thing I want to do is bring out the virtues of the theory. And one way to bring out the virtues of the theory is by looking at what you might call logically complex propositions. Because a benefit of the possible worlds theory is that it gives you a very simple theory of how logically complex propositions work. So we're going to look at logically complex propositions in the possible worlds theory of propositions. And then finally, we're going to use the possible worlds theory propositions to think about epistemological notions like belief and knowledge. And because as we'll see, there's a very natural theory of belief and knowledge that goes along with the possible worlds theory of propositions. We'll just call it the possible worlds theory of attitudes or belief and knowledge. Okay, so these are the four things we're going to do today. We're going to introduce the notion of proposition, we're going to talk about possible worlds theory propositions, first explaining what possible worlds are. We're going to then think about how logically complex propositions work in the possible worlds theory, and then finally we're going to use possible worlds to start thinking about epistemological notions like knowledge and belief. The reason why propositions are important for this class is because propositions are involved or play a key role in a variety of notions that we're interested in. So one place they crop up is in assertion. So we're going to be talking about assertion, particularly in kind of the middle to the late stages of the course. So I might assert something like the Earth is round. Typically, philosophers say, when I say this sentence, so this is an English sentence, the meaning of that, or the thing that I've asserted, is a proposition, namely the proposition that the Earth is round. So one reason propositions are interesting for us is because, well, they're the meanings of sentences, which are the things that we assert. And because we're interested in those, we have to have some grip on the notion of a proposition. So that's one reason. But another reason why we're going to be interested in them is because they're closely related to the epistemological notions we're going to be talking about. In particular, they are the things that we believe or disbelieve or know or fear or want. So for that reason, these attitudes are called propositional attitudes. So if you see somebody using the phrase propositional attitude, know that means something like knowledge or belief or fear or so on. So let's just say a little bit more about that. So let's consider the claim that Mulder believes there is extraterrestrial life. There is, I'll just write ET life. This is a claim about Mulder's beliefs. I'll put that in there. But we can see that it's a relationship between a person and a proposition. So belief here is a kind of relation between Mulder, person, and this thing, the proposition, that there is extraterrestrial life. This is a proposition. And in fact, this gives us a sort of handy way to test for whether something expresses a proposition. If a claim expresses a proposition like this, it can come after a that clause. So it can be the thing coming after a that clause. So of course, belief is one of the crucial notions that we're going to be interested in. And belief is a relationship between a person and a proposition. All of the same things go for knowledge. So let's take an example of a knowledge claim. Scully knows that Mulder is losing it. This is about knowledge, not about belief. But again, this claim expresses a relationship between a person and a proposition. So the relation is the knowledge relation, the person is Scully, and the proposition is the proposition that Mulder is losing it. So again, knowledge is a really important notion in epistemology, as we're going to see, and it too is a propositional attitude. It's a relationship between an attitude, between a person and a proposition. Just one last thing, which kind of follows from what we already said. When we talk about coordination, we're going to be talking about coordination. We're also going to be talking about agreement and disagreement. Here again, the notion of a proposition is crucial. So let's take agreement first. So suppose we say that Mulder and Scully, well, even though they differ in their beliefs about whether there's extraterrestrial life, they do both believe there's a deep state conspiracy. Saying they agree that there's a deep state conspiracy is just to say that they believe the same proposition, namely that there is a deep state conspiracy. Agreement, for two people to agree on something, is just for there to be some proposition that they both believe. So here again, in understanding the notion of agreement, we're using the notion of proposition. And as we'll see, when we think about coordination, basically what people think coordination is, or have suggested, is that it's basically a special kind of agreement. Between people's beliefs. So those are kind of the three important roles propositions will play that we're going to be interested in. They're the things we assert, they're the things we're related to when we believe things, and they play this role in agreement. We explain agreement by pointing to a proposition that both people believe. So that's why propositions are important and why we should be interested in them. As I said, it's going to be helpful to have a little theory of how propositions work to kind of guide us and see exactly what's going on when we think about various accounts of knowledge and belief. And the one I'm going to explain today is the possible worlds theory of propositions. So we'll move to that in the next video.